And then there's Orange is the New Black, which I do not watch.
Too close to home?
Well, no, it's not as good as the real thing. When you live through something like Orange is the New Black, the real characters are better.
What did you watch when you were in prison? Did you have access to Netflix there? No, they don't have.
In prison, it was BET television at all times of night. I had to get up really early to watch the news. You know, there's only one TV available, and you have to sit in a room on hard chairs, and you look up like this at the TV.
Oh my gosh!
So if I wanted to watch stock market and stuff like that, I had to get up really early and watch it by myself.
Do you watch Game of Thrones, though?
I have never watched one episode.
Okay, listen.
And Peter Dinklage, I made a movie with Peter Dinklage.
You were in a movie with Peter? I had no idea that you were in a movie.
I had a cameo with Peter in the last Adam Sandler movie called Pixels.
Oh.
And Peter he saved the world, and the president was giving him a present. For saving the world, and all he wanted was a threesome with me and Serena Williams.
And did that come to fruition?
Yes.
For the three of you?
Oh, no, not really.
That would have been one fucked up trio.
Yes, that would have been really weird.
Yeah.
Serena would have crushed poor Peter.
Yeah, and who knows where you would have come out of the mix.
And I haven't watched the Borgias either, because I can't stand torture.
I'm not into violence either.
And I've never watched that horrible, horrible movie about the crystal meth guys.
Oh, Breaking Bad?
Never watched it.
No, you've got to.
I can't.
It doesn't matter.
They're such
what you
ugly
think.
People.
It doesn't matter.
I can't
it doesn't
watch
matter.
It.
It's a story that anybody can watch. That defines the meaning of binge watching is Breaking Bad. You've got to get into it, Martha. You promise me.
I can't.
You won't promise me?
No.
Well, then, how are we supposed to promote your kitchen line
maybe
at Home Depot?